Let's look at the profitability analysis in this section. In our previous sections, we have covered cost elements, cost centers, profit centers, internal orders, and now we look at profitability analysis. These are all the other CEO objects, and it has a lot of relationship with profitability analysis. Let's look at the COPA hierarchy. So profitability analysis is with this controlling module, so CEO. So from now on, we'll refer it as COPA or COPA. Now in the COPA hierarchy, the highest node is the operating concern. So if you have the CEO module or the control module active, and if you have the profitability analysis active, then the highest node or the highest object is called operating concern. Now you are familiar with controlling area, and we can assign one or more controlling areas to one operating concern. So once again, we can assign two controlling areas or three controlling areas to the same operating concern. And you have seen before that when we create cost centers, profit centers, or internal orders, or any other CEO objects, we mention to which controlling area it belongs to. For example, this can be two cost centers, and it can belong to this controlling area. This can be two profit centers, and it can belong to this controlling area. This can be two internal orders, and it can belong to this controlling area. Similar on this side as well, this can be a cost center, and it can belong to this controlling area. And these two controlling areas can be assigned to one operating concern. Now we know we can also transfer costs between a cost center and another cost center within the same controlling area. It can also transfer costs from an internal order to an internal order or from a profit center to a profit center. So within the controlling area, you can transfer costs. However, you cannot transfer a cost from this cost center to this cost center because it's under different controlling area. So you can only make transfer of costs within the same controlling area. Now you have something called characteristics and values. We'll look at this in more detail later. So these are part of the operating concern. For a profitability analysis in an operating concern, you identify what are the characteristics and what are the values you're going to be using. And these characteristics and values in one operating concern can be shared across all the other lower levels. We'll look at this in more detail in the upcoming slides. So what is this COPA or what is this COPA? What does it do? It provides review of profitability, or you can analyze profitability for different dimensions. So PA, profitability analysis, it belongs to the controlling module, so you see your PA. So PA itself means profitability analysis. You can analyze profitability for different dimensions. So what are these dimensions? These dimensions are based on characteristics. For example, you can have sales group. It can be one type of characteristics. You can have your customer. It can be a type of characteristic. Customer groups, material groups, countries, regions, states, all these can be different characteristics. So you have your company code and you have your financial statement. For example, P&L statement. Because remember, CEO module always deals with the P&L statement. So you have revenues. For example, for this particular company code, I have revenue of $10,000. I have expenses of $6,000. So what is my profit or loss? So I make a profit of $10,000 minus $6,000, $4,000. Now this at a company code level or financial accounting level is sufficient. However, in terms of management accounting level, if you want to further analyze how much are my different segments are doing, how much am I selling to my wholesale group, how much am I selling to my retail group, how am I doing in different states, how am I doing in different countries, how am I doing in different industries. If you want to see those further analysis, then you need to have COPA implemented. By using COPA, you can analyze further. For example, I put here sales group 1 and sales group 2. This can be your wholesale group and this can be your retail sales group. So I can break this P&L into two smaller P&Ls based on the sales groups. So this 10,000 of revenue can be made up of, in wholesale group, I have made revenue of 8,000 and in